Okay, as I've been telling you, at the World Economic Forum, India and China are big focus areas, and part of that happens to be in the heart of where I am, which is the Congress Center. At the Congress Center at the moment, there are probably more than 2,500 people. All of them happen to be delegates, of which 35 to 40 happen to be cabinet minister level people coming in from across the world. Now, the big discussions here have been threefold. One, of course, is to rebalance the economy. The other is the inclusivity of China and India and the amount of risk that they might be exposed to in terms of their growth story. To what extent are they fueling inflationary pressures? And more importantly, how are they managing local issues? Because at the end of the day, India and China boast a great deal about domestic economies by sheer size of what they are. We had a chance to catch up with Sunil Mittal, who talked about India in a great deal. India Inclusive is a big campaign here, after all. And in that respect, India Inc. was put through some really tough questions about where is India headed in terms of controversy, in terms of governance deficit, especially after the recent letter written by several Indian corporation heads to the government talking about a governance deficit and a need to bridge that. Some of that has actually come through in Davos as a carry forward. So in that sense, the whole India Inclusive story seeing a little bit of shadow. Sunil Mittal put through some tough questions and admits to negative energies.
The letter, which has gone out from 14 eminent citizens, some business people, some from non-business area. I think there is a letter just highlighting some of the key issues from their point of view, asking the Prime Minister to focus on those issues. But broadly, what are they saying? India needs to deal with some of the issues that are facing us today more boldly. We need to quell some of the issues that are coming on the surface, including in the area of governance. And I think some parts are absolutely agreeable by all of us. I think you and me both can agree on that. The telecom, I think we have a new minister, and we can all agree once again. We find lawyer trained by his profession, articulate, has a very clear mind. We are confident that we have now a minister who's got a good idea of the issues on the table. What we want is that the shifts in regulatory regime which keeps on happening in the short term are avoided. And that's what we expect in the national telecom policy, which is coming through. The balancing between growth and environmental issues is critical for industry, and that's where we are working along with the government. We have, again, a great leader in Jairam Ramesh, who is dealing with the world bodies to ensure that we can get a growth within, hopefully, the right balance of environment and growth. India is a positive story today. It's growing at 9%, a $1 trillion economy. When it adds $90 billion of wealth, it does percolate down into the lower end of the society. We need to keep our positivity intact. I am worried that we are becoming too negative about our own country. We need to really go and celebrate some of the big successes that are coming out in the corporate world and also the small successes that we are seeing in the hinterland.
With me, a special guest, Harish Manwani, who's joined me here. He's, of course, been part of all these sessions and gathering what is the Davos buzz on day one. Harish, what do you pick up?